What's up everyone, this is Aravind back from Explain Tech for another special video, and in this video we're going to be looking at the unboxing and overview of this OnePlus Nord. So what is Nord? You guys might be already wondering what is Nord. I'll tell about that later, but before that, we all know that OnePlus is the king of premium smartphone segment. That too in India, they are the king, beating even Apple and Samsung. So my question is, why should they come into mid-ranger when they're already successful in a particular segment? The key answer and the main reason is, for a country like India, budget is the key role. And for a budget around 20 to 30K, we should have a segment called mid-ranger. And OnePlus Nord is the answer from OnePlus for that particular segment. So as usual, if this is your first time here, like, share and subscribe, and it will be highly appreciable if you share with your friends and also tell them to subscribe. So let's not waste the time anymore. Let's get started. So guys, this is the OnePlus Nord retail unit box, and it's different from the previous OnePlus devices because we used to have a red color or a white color type of box, but this is different because it's a different segment, so they have to be different. Okay, so they have written OnePlus Nord, as you can see, and to the side we have OnePlus. And this side we have OnePlus Nord, and looking at the back, it says it's the blue marble color. Yeah, of course, the variant we have is the blue marble color. We do have another variant called the Onyx Black. I found this to be quite superb, so I went with this color. And we have 12 GB of RAM and 256 GB of internal storage. Okay, that's okay. We don't have a memory card slot expansion, meaning for the base variant they offer, it just comes with 6 GB of RAM and 64 GB of internal storage. So I'm wondering how it will be sufficient for heavy users, or even for light users. You know, nowadays 64 GB is not going to be enough. Okay, that's what we get. And as you can see, the pricing here is 29,999. Yeah, of course, that's the price that has been sold in Amazon Indian website. Okay, and we do have other details like the contents inside the box, where it is manufactured and other stuffs, and it has the Qualcomm branding and no other spec explanation or like that. Okay, we'll just open up the box and look inside for the contents and phone itself. So guys, we don't have any kind of seal in this Nord box. It just came with a wrap, a plastic wrap. I removed that. So let's open this. 3, 2, 1, and there we go. Straight away we have the phone itself. So let's take that and keep aside and come to that later. So the blue color already, so it's really nice looking at that. It's a new color actually for OnePlus. So okay, let's keep that aside and see the contents inside. The accessories actually, we have another cover looking. Okay, so it's a pouch. Let's see what else we have. So yes, it says welcome letter, and it says everything about Nord and thing. If you want to just pass and read that. Okay, so I'm wondering whether they're giving Nord stickers. So that's special already in the OnePlus 8 series and 7 series. So as you can see, we have the membership card like we saw in the OnePlus 8 series. So it says Red Cable Club. Let's take that and see how it is. Okay, so it says Red Cable Club. And a good thing about the OnePlus in the recent devices, like I think from OnePlus 7 they're offering this. If you're owning an OnePlus device, just go to the settings, sign in with your OnePlus account, and after signing in itself, you'll be just getting a free 6 months extended warranty plan. So if you're already having a 1 year warranty, you can just extend that up to another 6 months. So it's a free offering for some other brands like Samsung and all. You know, you have to pay an extra bucks for that extra warranty and stuff. So OnePlus is giving that for free. I think from OnePlus 7, OnePlus 8, and even for Nord, they should be having that. Okay, so it says safety information booklets. Okay, we don't have to see that. Quick start guide, SAR value and stuff. Yeah, and the special thing, we have the stickers, and this time it's a transparent sticker, so it's nice. I'll just remove that and stick it in somewhere of my house. So okay, let's see what else we have. So we have the warp charge. Let's check the rating, as we do always. So as you can see, it's of course a 30 watt fast charger. So that's what they call the warp charge. And we have the cable. So it's the type A to type C cable with that beautiful OnePlus red accent. Okay, so we'll just keep all these things to the side and come back to the device itself. So guys, I've just moved everything aside and let's come back to the device itself. So as you can see, for the first time if you're holding the OnePlus Nord, you would frankly say it is one of the best compact smartphones out there in the industry. It is that much lightweight that you won't even have a feel of holding a smartphone in your hand. So the build quality is also nice, and also the weight balance has been done quite superbly in this device. So as you can see, it just glitters in that beautiful marble blue color, and I would just call this a sky blue because it is just resembling me of that sky blue. So let's boot the device for the first time. So it gave me haptic feedback and it says OnePlus by Android. So meanwhile it boots up, let me give you a physical overview. So in the bottom we have the primary noise cancellation mic, a dual SIM slot, a type C port for charging, a single speaker grill. It's actually different actually, as you can see. So to this side we have the power button and the usual OnePlus thing, the alert slider. So as you can see, we can switch between ring, vibrate and silent. And to the top we have the noise cancellation mic. I think it's the secondary one, we had the primary here. Okay, so this side we have the volume rockers, and as you can see, the volume rocker sounds are really clickable. I'll just show you that. So as you heard, it was really clickable and it just gave me a premium feel. And to the back we have the quad camera setup. We'll just see about that in the later part of the video. We have the OnePlus branding here. It is written as OnePlus. And I have to say guys, this side frame is actually plastic, but it just gives a feel of having a stainless steel finish. Guys, I think it has already booted up. So as you can see, we have the ambient display, and this is the lock screen wallpaper that you get by default. Since it's a blue color, we have that blue accent wallpaper. So let's go to the home screen, and as you can see, it is really smooth. And guys, I just forgot to say this thing, it's a 5G phone of course, because it is powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon 765G, and also it has that 90Hz refresh rate, so it's really smooth like the usual OnePlus devices. I don't know whether the refresh rate gets captured in the camera, but it's really smooth. Considering the budget of 27,000, I think it's a great offering from OnePlus. And we'll just go to settings, and as usual, look at the version of Android it is currently running on. And as you can see, it is running on Android 10 out of the box, so that's a good thing. And the spec details are given. So the processor is Snapdragon 765G, as I told you before. The storage is 12256. The camera is 48+8+5+2, so that's really huge. And in the front we have 32 and 8 megapixels, so that's good. And as you can see, we have that 6.4-inch 90Hz Super AMOLED display. And yeah, as I told you, it's really is smooth, very smooth, butter smooth. And I'll just show you the storage that we get out of the box. So as you can see, 30 GB is already been used out of that 256 GB, so that's a good thing. And let's check whether it has the option of switching between 90Hz and 60Hz. So let's check that. It should be under advanced, and as you can see, we have refresh rate is defaultly set to 90Hz, and we can also switch back to 60Hz if you want a better battery life. So it's a 4000 mAh battery, and we'll have to see how the battery life is, because after a usage of nearly 1 or 2 weeks only, we have to say about the battery. So I'll just say about that in my full review. So let's go to the camera and see how it is. So as you can see, it really is nice, the usual OnePlus interface. So it's not fast, it's having some shutter lag, not fast like their premium segment devices. And we have the telephoto lens, as you can see, and also the wide angle, so that's a good thing. And we have a portrait mode. Okay, so even we can go for 2x in portrait also, that's a good thing. Okay, so nightscape, so that's a night mode, and a dedicated pro mode. It should have all the settings. Yeah, as you can see, it is a dedicated full-fledged pro mode. So going to video. So let's check whether it has 4K 60fps like we always do. So for the rear camera, interestingly, we have 4K 30fps only, but for the front camera we have 4K 60fps. It really is different. I don't know how OnePlus is giving that, because in phones usually, you know, we have 60fps at the back and 30fps at the front, but here it is ulta. I don't know how. Okay, so yeah, that's the video interface, as you can see. And slow motion we have, and usually we don't have 960fps in OnePlus, so let's check that. So there's no setting also. Okay, so it should be 480 pixels only. Okay, and panorama, so the thing we don't actually use much, and the time lapse mode if you are using it. Okay, so that's the modes that we get with the camera. So I'm not going to be getting in depth with the camera now, because I'll be doing a dedicated camera review, but I'll be posting a bunch of photos and video samples. Recording this part of the video with the rear facing camera of the OnePlus Nord at max 4K 60fps, and even the audio is also via the internal microphone. And this should give you an idea how it performs at outdoor conditions, because I'm taking this under direct sunlight. And guys, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to walk, because it has an optical image stabilization, and let's see how it stabilizes the video. So it's really smooth, as you can see. We don't have any shakings in the video, so the OIS is effective in this phone. And also we have that telephoto lens, so let's check how it fares. So it really is decent for the pricing, I would say. So guys, another good thing about this device is that it can shoot videos with the ultra wide mode turned on. So as you can see, we can see a lot of things into a frame, so that is possible only because of that ultra wide camera. So these are some of the camera sample shots taken outdoors. This is the normal mode, and previous one was the wide angle, and this is 2x optical zoom. And once again we have the wide angle, the normal mode, and as you can see the clouds at the background, their exposure levels are very good, so decent for a budget phone. And these are taken indoors. And one thing I noticed with OnePlus Nord is that it tends to oversaturate the colors when we are taking, or when you are trying to take photos inside the house. So look at here, the red color is oversaturated, and that tends to make the photo more artificial. So guys, the phone's biometrics has not been set yet, so we'll just head over to settings and set that. I'll just turn off my Wi-Fi because unwanted ads are coming. Okay, I'll go to security and lock screen. I'll just set up the fingerprint and come back. So guys, I have set up the fingerprint, and I'll just show you how fast it is. So it really is fast, as you can see. No lags or anything. As soon as you keep the finger, it just opens up. So that's really is convenient. It is just as fast as like the premium OnePlus devices. So that's nice. So as I have told you before, if you're doing any work, and if you get any messages, or if you want to just open the screen, just tap and press and it will open. So that's a convenient feature. Let's check whether we have some of the OnePlus alone features. So let's go to settings and go to customization. And there, if you can see, we have the clock styles. So we have tons and tons of clock styles, as you can see. So I think this one is good. We'll check that. Yeah, as you can see, it is really stylish, you know. The default one was good, but this one is really stylish. So we have a lot of options, as you can see. We can just keep according to our taste. And also we can change the fingerprint animation, as you can see. And also the accent color, so let's change to red color. And as you can see, everything has changed to red. And we have this dark mode and normal mode. So nuance dark is dark mode, okay. And we have this tone, what is that? Yeah, it is again the dark mode. System icons, okay. So it is defaultly set to OnePlus pack. And going to display, let's reduce the font size to small, and because it just gives you a premium feel having the icon set to small. So guys, let's try some gaming in this device, because it is powered by the Qualcomm Snapdragon 765G. So it should be powerful. So let's check that. Let me turn on the Wi-Fi and let me keep the brightness somewhat. Let's go to PUBG. We'll try that and see how it is. It's too much bright, man. The panel is really bright. You know, we can't keep above 40%. So it is that much bright. So it's checking for some updates. Yeah, it has gone inside. Okay, so the game is on. Let's check the settings for graphics, because that's important. And let's go. Okay. So let's go to settings and check the graphics settings. So it is defaultly set to HDR and ultra and colorful, and also anti-aliasing is turned on. Okay, so that's good. So let's start a game. Let's go to this arena. Okay, it is downloading. Okay, okay, so let's go to this team deathmatch and play a game and check how the graphics is. So guys, even I'm holding this in one hand, and as I told you before, it's really is lightweight that you can't even feel you're holding a phone in the hand. So okay, I think it's giving some instructions. Okay, we don't want that. Yeah. Yeah, it's really smooth, guys. See, as you can see, no lag or anything. It just feels like I think the match has started already. Oh, I'm actually weak in snipers. Okay, so the first kill we are getting, and we'll just move on. Okay, so they have killed us. We'll change the gun because I'm weak in snipers. We'll change to Groza and see how it is. Okay, let's find for some enemies. Where are they? Where are those guys? Okay, so we have taken a kill with Groza. Oh, they have killed us. Okay, so that's what it is, guys. That's the gameplay of PUBG. You know, it's really smooth, as you can see. No lag or anything. No stutter or anything. It just plays like how the flagship devices play. So, guys, that's the quick unboxing and overview of this OnePlus Nord. As usual, if this is your first time here, like, share and subscribe. And, guys, you have been giving some valuable feedbacks for my videos, and I just feel proud that you are watching all of my videos. So just keep supporting and give your valuable feedbacks. I'll just be going through all of your comments and try to improve in my upcoming videos. So I'll see you in the next video. Until then, bye and goodbye from Aravind.